Everyone, so I'm sorry my channel has been a bit dead lately. Just life and work and everything has kind of taken over, and I just haven't had time to put in the effort to make new videos, which is such a shame, and I've actually missed doing it quite a lot. So the videos that are going to be coming up are going to be quite kind of easy, quick ones for me to do, just so I've got some content for you to watch. But hopefully I can bring the quality back up once things, ease a bit. And I do sound a bit nasal probably because I do have a stinking cold. Anyway, yes, I don't have makeup on, and that is because I keep playing with my hair. Sorry, that's annoying. I am going to do my updated, I say updated, I don't think I did a daily routine before. So this is what I'm currently wearing makeup wise. Some of the time, if I'm honest with you, my daily routine would involve me having toothpaste on my face or something like that, but I don't think you want to see that. So, I will show you what I do when I actually stop being a hermit and leave the house. And I think the reason it's changed is because I've gotten some new products lately through some blogging work, and I've just really enjoyed, trying them out, actually spending time on my face. Because usually I was just like, whatever, just get it done, cover up the spots, the eye bags, and then done. But now I'm actually, enjoying the process and finding it quite therapeutic. So let's begin. Waffling enough. What is that? One of my rings is on top of my foundation for some reason. Now, if I'm honest with you, I've not been wearing foundation most of the time because none of it matched my skin still. I still got a slight bit of holiday tan, so. Yeah, most of them are just the wrong colour, including the one I'm about to use. But for the sake of this video, we will use foundation. And today I'm using the number 7 Instant Radiance Foundation, which is a radiant boost for tired and stressed skin, which has SPF 15. And I am stressed and I'm tired and I need some radiance. So let's try this. I'm just going to apply with my fingers today because, surprise, surprise, I've lost the brush. So, as you can see, completely the wrong colour. It's got far too much like bluey and pinky tones. I definitely need something that's got a bit more kind of yellow and brown in to match leftover tan. But actually, I'm off to Greece on a press trip next week, just for 3 days. But I imagine after that, because Greece is so freaking hot, I'm gonna have a bit of tan added on. It's a weird way of saying I'm gonna get a bit of a tan, isn't it? So yeah, that's foundation. It's actually left me looking blue and uneven, which is clearly the look you're going for, guys, isn't it? I think we can sort that out though. I'm trying to do it in the camera viewer, but it's not really a fair representative of what it's actually looking like. It's actually not as bad in real life. It's actually blended quite well. And it does give you a bit of radiance, this foundation, because it's not too dense and it kind of gives slightly dewy effect. God, I really look like I'm blue. So, for the sake of you guys, I will use a foundation that I have happily been using because it seems to work even though I've even got a bit of a tan, and that is this Sonia. It's reflecting. Oh, Jesus. There you go. Sonia Mineral Foundation, which I actually love, and it gives surprisingly good amount of coverage. So I'm putting this over, which will just even me out a bit more. I love this brush. This is the Blank Canvas Cosmetics F22 brush. It feels absolutely lovely. Sorry, it probably looks like I'm doing something really dodgy under here. I should shake above camera level. I'm just trying to get some of the mineral powder up. There we go. I wish I got like sexy phlegm. I always just get the gross phlegm. And I keep waking up with a mouth full of green, which is really not what one wants. Okay, so that's good. I'm looking less zombie-like on camera now, that's good. So, next up, I'm actually doing not too bad in terms of big spots. I've got a few small blemishes, but nothing big. But we will tackle that a little bit later. So next up, Hoola. Hoola is one of those brands that all the beauty YouTubers go on about, and I was like, yeah, yeah, can't be that good. But actually, bloody love it. So this is the bronzing powder, Poudre Bronzante. And what I like about it is, one, this little square thing, which makes it super easy to contour. So I just put it at the bottom of my cheekbones to create the illusion of a really sharp, see, like, oh look, do it again on the other side. Oh, I forgot to blow it. So you can see, look, I've suddenly got cheekbones. Don't worry, I kind of will blend that in a bit more in a touch. And I've been doing it a bit up here too, just kind of reduce the size of my massive spam. There you go. And I guess you could do it on your jawline as well if you feel you need it. I've got a massive chin, so I probably don't need it, but I guess that's a little tip for anyone that worries that they're a bit lacking in the jawline department. So that's really nice. And what's good about it is that it's matte, so if you've got any blemishes or bumps, like I've got quite a lot of like bumps from scarring and stuff like that, it doesn't cling to it like a glittery one will, and it doesn't like kind of sparkle on the blemish. So matte is definitely better if you have got kind of troublesome skin. So what shall we do next? Okay, next up, I got this in a Motel Rocks goodie bag, which is highly exciting for me because it's not something I'd usually be able to afford or would allow myself to purchase, just because it's not cheap and I have things that are kind of more necessary I should spend my money on. That said, now I've got it, it is absolutely beautiful and I actually look forward to using it. So I'm applying 13 to my whole eyelid like that, using the brush that comes with it because I actually really like the brush. And 13 is kind of just a very pale, it's this one here, pale creamy colour. So just add that and it kind of gives the illusion of an even skin tone. And if like me you've got kind of veins that show through on your eyelids and it's not quite, you know, that flawless base, it's nice to just put a bit of this on to at least give the illusion that it's a bit more flawless. So yeah, you can see very subtle colour. So I've never been one for eyeshadow, mainly because it makes me look like a man in drag, as I always say to you. But if I keep it quite subtle, I can just about get away with it. So next up, I've been using Password, which is this kind of, I guess it's a grey blue colour. And I've just been, use a clean brush if you've got a clean brush. I don't have a spare clean brush, so I am currently wiping the 13 colour off on my knee that is showing through my cutout jeans. So I'm now going to put on a bit of Password blow. And then I'm just putting it in the crease, like that, swishing round and round and round. That's super subtle, so I'm going to put a bit more on. More on, it sounded like I was saying, you moron. There we go. See that? And then I'm going to do the same on the other eye, because otherwise we're going to look wonky donk. A bit closer in on that one. See, as you can see, it's very subtle, because subtle is what I need to do. Now, I'm going to add a bit of a highlight to under the brow here, and that is using 13. What am I doing? I don't want to use 13. Ugh. I'm going to refer to my Naked 2 palette and use Foxy, which is like very creamy, there's no sparkle in there, and that's just a slightly different hue, but is really good for creating that highlight. Right, if like me you're not that good at blending, get a clean fluffy brush, this is the Blank Canvas E42, and just kind of work at that crease colour that you've put in till it looks more seamless. Done. I'm going to turn to brows and I'm going to use Brow Yings. I don't know what you call it. It's the Benefit product basically, and it contains powder and wax, and I've gone for light because although my brows are quite dark, because I'm a natural blonde, it looks really odd if I go super dark, so it's much better if I go kind of natural. So just kind of using my existing brows as the template, and just, you know, following the hairs and just making them slightly more dramatic. I'm just using the powder for this. I don't pluck my eyebrows or do anything with them, just because I don't trust myself to do a good job, and I can't deal with the faff of going to someone on a regular occasion to sort them out. It really scares me when I see those things on Instagram that says stuff, you know, relating to don't trust someone with bad brows and stuff like that, because I reckon everyone looks at me and goes, God, terrible brow she's got. But, you know, there are more important things in life. That said, I should really work on my unibrow, because that's really quite fluffy in the middle, but I do enjoy stroking it, so, you know, it has its benefits. So I'm going to create just a very subtle cat eye, and I'm using the Superliner Perfect Slim L'Oreal Paris, which is actually alright. It still doesn't compare to the Ico, which I still love, and I still am devastated that I lost, but it actually is not bad at all, and is quite good at creating a relatively neat effect. I tell you what, doing eyeliner on camera is terrifying. I've always been a bit heavy-handed with my liner, so I have lately been trying to do it slightly thinner. But the problem is, as soon as you make a mistake, how's that looking? As soon as you make a mistake, it ends up getting thicker and thicker to cover up the mistake, so you end up where you always were. Okay. One. Oh, Christ alive, see? I probably look like I'm doing it very cack-handedly, but it's because I'm nervous and I'm doing liner on camera, which I said is, I think, oh no! They don't match at all. Cracking work, Soph, cracking work. But do you know what? Like I always say to you guys, pretty sure you don't come to my channel for my beauty installments, because I'm not exactly very good at it. So, we're going to just deal with the fact that it's asymmetric and say that it matches my quirky personality. So next up, I'm using my Lancôme Dorama Hypnose Mascara, which is still my all-time fave, and I'm going to do my lower lashes first. And I have quite long lower lashes, actually. and I kind of like to enhance them. I know some people think it kind of looks spidery and unattractive to do so, but I think if you've got something that's kind of reasonably strong, you might as well enhance it and just, you know, embrace it. Oh, mascara hair is about to happen. So let's get in a bit closer, because you guys like close-ups, don't you? Well, you might not on my face, but in general, I think YouTubers like to see details, don't they? You see? See how this mascara is so good at adding drama? Well, that's the name, isn't it? I wonder if they're also hypnotic, like the name suggests. I don't know. You tell me. Are you under my spell? I don't know. So, yeah. So, there's a lower lash. Now, if I'm honest with you, on an average day, I don't curl my top lashes. My top lashes. Purely because I can never find my bleeding curlers. But let's see if I can find them. Then I might do that. Be right back. I literally can't believe it. My camera decided to die. I don't know what I went up to, but I'm hoping we didn't lose too much. So I think I was saying that you need to apply the Mint Juleps Lip Scrub all over your lips. So you've got a kind of clean base and smooth base to apply. So I've lost everything now. I'm all estate to apply your lip stuff. So first up, we're going to go with Nice and Spicy Pro Longwear Lip Pencil by MAC. I've not used eyeliner for most of my life. I always associated it with people that did those like really like noticeable lines and it just looked really cheap, but I realised it doesn't have to be that way. So I'm just going to line outside of my lips. Sorry, I'm just going to line the outside of my lips. You know, whenever I go to makeup counters, they always overline my lips, and I'm just like, I've lived with these lips all my life. I'm fine that they're thin and witchy. I'm totally comfortable with that, so no need to plump them up for me, thanks. But if you want to, then that's your prerogative. So, yeah, just colour it in. And I colour in then the rest of it, just because it makes the lipstick stay a bit longer. So, yeah. So that's the base, and then we add Velvet Teddy Matte by MAC, which I know is a bit of a YouTuber favourite. Yeah, pressed together. Now, I don't know if I lost this in the video or not, but I did the lower lash line, waterline, I think you guys call it, just like this. Now, this lovely Revlon Photo Ready Kajal also has this great little applicator at the end if you want to create a really smudgy eye look, and it really works very well. So I really recommend this product, actually. There you go. I really miss having kind of rouge cheeks when I've just used bronzer, so I like to add a little bit of pinky blush, and I use my favourite Trio, which is the new ID one that I got from TK Maxx for next to nothing, and just mix the colours and add a bit to my cheeks there. And you can see there's a slight shimmer there, and that's because I've let the brush graze across that middle bit, which has a bit of sparkle to it. So yeah. There you go. Now, to add a bit of further definition to my brows, I like to add kind of a strip of concealer just along here. Ideally, you'd have kind of a squared off brush to make this kind of very easy and accurate process. If you see, just by doing that, it kind of defines the brow a bit more. Yeah. That's basically it. But just make sure you blend it well so it doesn't look like you've got weird white stripes across your eyes. I've also added concealer to my nose here because I'm prone to redness around there. I think that's from years of squeezing blackheads from my nose, which is something I know you shouldn't do, but it's kind of irresistible sometimes. And PS, you really shouldn't, if possible, use concealer, these little applicators, straight on your skin. You should ideally dab on your hand like that and then use a clean brush and put it on, or some other sort of applicator, because you know this is full of germs if you keep spreading it around your skin and stuff. Just a little tip, even though I haven't followed it, but I can't find any of my brushes. So what else do we need to do? I'm just going to check everything is well blended. Yeah, so I think this is my finished day look. I know that I am terrible at applying makeup. I know I've done a lot of things wrong, but I just wanted to show you what I do, and just show you the kind of neutral everyday look I've been sporting lately. I'm sure you can do a much better job. Hopefully I'll get better and you'll see some progress as I do more beauty videos. If this isn't too embarrassing or awful to watch, I'll do some more. Oh, something in my eye. I'll do some more, give me some ideas, whatever you want really. So yeah, that's my look. Shall I give some close-ups? I think that's what beauty vloggers do. This is always awkward. What face should you pull in this moment? Do you do like, try and do like sultry and sexy, or do you go, I don't know. Oh, I haven't got any lipstick on my teeth, that's the first. So yeah, so just a subtle feline cat eye, lashings of mascara, and coloured cheeks and a neutral lip. Thanks for watching. Please leave comments, it's always fun to read. Obviously, please don't be mean, but lovely comments or just constructive criticism, welcome. And thanks again, lots of love. Hope you're all doing okay and you're not snotty like me. Bye.